Welcome back, and we continue with our race debate.
Culture is held in great esteem in South Africa, but the question then becomes how to move towards understanding without forgetting, and how to remember without rekindling the divisive past. Art, recreational activities, and social media have played a crucial role towards social cohesion, and sometimes the lack thereof. Today we are joined by Yusuf Abramji, lead SA activist, and DDG of Internal Governance, Ms. Khanedi, to shed more light. Welcome. Beloved, someday when we are old, we will still be young. Nestled in each other's bosom under Africa's rendition of the Shakespearean Midsummer Night's Dream, beckoned under open skies and open prayers, bidding promise against open bonfire, drawing miracle of warmth in a cold world. Unbridled, unbreakable belief, riveting paradigms of thought and unfathomable insight, strewn as a hurricane of wind, ever reaching, ever sifting, reeling gentle relief at best, an utter pandemonium at worst, consecrated by the sandglass of the ages, pages of mind and precedent, invisible and yet ever transcendent. Someday, when we are old, we will still be young.
A rapist doesn't have to be a stranger to be legitimate. Someone you never saw. But if you've been in public with him, danced one dance, kissed him goodbye, lightly, with a closed mouth, pressing charges will be as hard as trying to keep your legs closed while five fools try to run a train on you. These men, friends of ours, who smile nice, stay employed, take us out to dinner, lock the door behind you, and we are left with the scars. Being betrayed by men who know us and who expect, like the stranger we always thought was coming, that we will submit. We must have known. Women relinquish all personal rights in the presence of a man who could be considered a rapist, especially if he has been considered a friend.